first gentleman I'd like to introduce to you tonight, like I said, is a very dear friend of mine, retired Army Lieutenant Colonel Mike Baumann. Mike hails from Olivia, Minnesota, a graduate of St. Thomas Senior High School in Bloomington, Minnesota, and is a distinguished military graduate of the University of Minnesota. Commissioned a second lieutenant in the field artillery in September 1985, he has served in Army units not only in the United States, but Latin America, Asia, Europe, and the Middle East. He is a veteran of Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan and Operation Iraqi Freedom in Iraq. His education includes a Bachelor's of Arts degree in Political Science and International Relations from the University of Minnesota and from Texas A&M. Mike commanded an Army Battalion Task Force with the 1st Cavalry Division fighting in Baghdad, Iraq in March of 04 to March of 05. His military career spanned 20 years, where he served in leadership positions and staff positions from platoon level all the way up to joint combat staff. Some of the military awards and decorations that Mike proudly wears is the Legion of Merit, the Bronze Star Medal, the Meritorious Service Medal, the Joint Service Commendation Medal, the Iraq Campaign Medal, the Ranger Tab, the Jungle Expert Badge, the Parachute Badge, and the Air Assault Badge. Mike is the author of a book called The Just Fire, excellent book, Transforming to Win in Iraq. You can, if you like, it's on sale outside the door. Please buy one on the way out. Mike would gladly autograph it for you. Today, he's a chief financial officer in the St. Paul Public Schools and lives in Lakeville, Minnesota. Will you give a very warm Brainerd welcome to Lieutenant Colonel Mike Baumann?
I would like to say, thank you. I'll tone it down a little bit, no command voice. I would like to say, first of all, thank you to the College Veterans Club for having me, and to the Minnesota Freedom Council, thank you very much, and a special thank you to Mr. Guy Green for inviting my team up here to participate in this great event. As Colonel Repia said, I am a retired Army Lieutenant Colonel. I commanded Task Force 121 in Baghdad from March 04 to March 05. And I'd like to direct your attention to the screen on my left, your right, and then I'll have my comments. Thank you.
Warrior is—it's a precious commodity. What's at the core is moral courage, and that's what every warrior possesses.
Duty, honor, country.
The ultimate experience a man can have is being in combat and seeing if you can handle that.
Some people were meant to be 911, and some people were meant to call 911.
Boats were being blown out of the water in the process of trying to land on the beach at Omaha.
Train, train, train.
In my training, you know, a pain is weakness leaving the body.
The more difficult the standards were for soldiers, sailors, Marines, airmen to attain, the stronger that bond was.
You make the plan, you go, and it's until it's done. There's no halfway, you just got to go, just balls to the wall, there's no other way.
You don't create war fighters in a vacuum. You have to subject them to heat and pressure until you get diamonds.
The more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war.
For America, I was and I still am willing to give up my life, give up my family, everything.
I need to go. It was just, I needed to defend my country.
The military is all about what you give. It's not so much about what you receive.
Everybody owes this country something.
Warriors have a calling, and they would serve their country if you never gave them any battles. are no ribbons, are no accolades.
As an American, as somebody who had the ability to do something, I felt it was my duty to do it because I can, I need to.
Sometimes it's not enough that you do your best. Sometimes you have to do what's required. Sometimes they're dark and even heinous, but they're necessary. And that's what often is required. And it's not our best that we have to do, but it's the thing that's required. Sometimes we have to take out the trash and be willing to do what's required.
You know, you're leaving your family, and some make a sacrifice, and it's the ultimate sacrifice.
He got it in the neck and in the head a few times, but the glass was flying every place.
We got hit hard. It was bloody, too. I mean, it was real bloody. A lot of blood, a lot of pieces of people, pieces of machinery, you know, pieces of gear strewn around. Gross smell of flesh burning.
You know you're going to bleed, but you also know that the mission and the accomplishment of that mission are grander than your own being. You were welded together in a way that you could never be broken apart again.
Fearless brothers.
As a unit, you know, you don't want to leave your brothers out there. You know, I feel bad because I lost. There's.
I owe everything that I have right now to that man right there, Doc Thompson. Doc Thompson got hit by an IED on his third deployment to Iraq. And he didn't make it through. He didn't have somebody there to help him. So he passed away.
It's very exacting if you go to a military funeral. Everything from a 21-gun salute to how the flag is folded or presented to try and let the family know how much they meant to us. The people that we have lost died doing what they believed in. Oftentimes they had lived more in the short period of time doing the things that they had done than people who get up and go to the exact same job doing the exact same thing year after year after year.
This is a country that still produces warriors. Once we lose the ability to produce those warriors, then we've lost the ability to maintain our country.
By golly, this country is the greatest country in the world. And if we don't watch it, we're going to be knocked off of our perch.
The United States is the beacon of light. Whether we want to admit it or not, people look up to us and as the moral courage, the moral compass of the world.
The only regret I have right now is that I'm not on the battlefield as we speak.
It's the land of the free. It's the way it's got to be.
It's the greatest country on the face of the planet. And it's worth my life. I know that for sure. I'd give it again.